This is a general introduction to my online courses for the spring semester of 2020 at San Jose State University. There's a few points I want to go over. The university expects that you put in about 9 hours of work into each 3-credit course per week. So, since this is online, the only way I have of deciding how much time you've put into it is through your homework responses each week. So you'll be called upon to do a significant amount of writing in this class. You'll be graded on how much thought and how much work you've put into each topic. That's reflected in the organization and the detail and reasoning. Not necessarily opinions, but I'll get to that. The very best responses and the worst responses that I get will determine what an A plus and a C are. So if you're not satisfied with a grade and I haven't given you a detailed explanation, which I probably won't, it just means that others have clearly put more work into it than you have this time around, and you just need to do a little better. That's a good one. So I'll have probably around 120 of these to do to grade each week, and I might fall a little behind, but in any case, always check on your grade. Check to see that your document's been submitted properly. It needs to be in either a Word format or a PDF format. And when you get a grade, there might be comments associated with that document that I may have left. I want you to be aware of those. Always check back. And always check for announcements once a week. And I'll get to that. So, I may message you personally about something, and you can message me, and we can carry on a conversation within Canvas that way. But let's not do it with regard to a particular assignment. Comments I leave for an assignment that are pinned to that assignment, I'm not going to check back on necessarily. This semester, the courses are organized differently from previous semesters. So, just in case you are offered, don't even think about recycling previous semester's work. Everything's going to be different, and even if it's not completely different, Canvas keeps a record of everything for me, and I can use an app to check for plagiarism, which results in a 0 grade. Videos are a big part of this course. The videos I've chosen carefully because there's a lot of junk out there and there's a lot of stuff that is not really up to par, and it takes a long time to search for good material. So it's important to me that you watch them, and that the ones that are really conveying a lot of information, that you watch them carefully and that you take notes and that you reflect that in the responses that you give me for the homework questions, some of which will clearly refer to these videos. And watch them on something other than a phone, something bigger, full screen preferably. So it being the spring of 2020, we'll probably be barraged with politics and feelings about politics, and I'm just telling you ahead of time, I want to keep our classes on a different plateau, what I consider a higher plateau, what's going on down there. So opinions are far less important, my opinions are less important, and quite frankly, your opinions are less important at this point than the task we have of really getting you to learn something substantive about the topics we're going over. So, once again, your responses can reflect opinion if you want, but I'm much more interested in the evidence or the arguments that you use, the logic that you use in forming those opinions, than I am in the opinions themselves. And you can just write in a very reflective or observational way if you prefer, and pose your own questions. It's often more helpful to pose questions than to constantly try to answer them. I don't know whether Canvas dumps my announcements into your email, but if it does, try not to let that happen. My announcements are meant to take the place of lectures, so they can be long-winded, they can be topical, they can express or point you to things that I've discovered after the beginning of the semester. I want you to keep checking back on them. They'll often offer you advice in a general way about homework responses or the final paper. So don't let it get dumped into your email, and don't read them as email. I avoid email if I can. I don't use San Jose State's email server. I have a private one, but I prefer that we carry on conversations in Canvas, which works just fine. And if you have an emergency, you can text me on my private phone. I'll get it immediately wherever I am. Okay, that's fine. Being late with your homework is not an emergency. Just get it in when you can. Okay, everything has to be in by the end of the semester. Everything, or it gets a zero. So I'll embed this video in the first announcement, and I'll also list some of these notes, and if there's anything that I've forgotten, I'll add them to the notes. So, just to summarize, I want you to see these courses as truly a learning experience, which you'll have total control over, since I'm not present telling you what to do all the time. Read each assignment carefully, read the syllabus carefully, read my announcements. If you have any questions or you have anything to offer, please send me a message through Canvas, and we can all have a good time, because it's a lot more fun when you're open and you're using your senses and your reasoning, and absorbing what's out there. It's a lot more fun to live that way.